It's me. And you're probably sitting at home right now wondering, why is she holding her head in her hand? But that's none of your concern. You're here for a reason, and so am I. In today's video, I'll be teaching you guys how to construct a frontal wig from start to finish. In this video, I'll be showing you guys frontal placement, which includes where to place your frontal on your wig cap before sewing it down, so that when you put it on, it can ensure that your entire hairline is covered. Along with my technique and pattern that I use to sew in my tracks that allowed me to create a perfect frontal wig, and some other tips and tricks that you could use on your next wig. So without further ado, let's begin. Okay, so before we begin, today's hair is sponsored by Nadula Hair Company. If you are looking for affordable hair, but also quality hair, I definitely would recommend Nadula. I didn't really have any bad experiences with this hair. The only thing that I would probably say is that it had a little bit too many flyaways for me, but that's definitely manageable. So if you're looking to look bomb on a budget, I definitely recommend Nadula Hair. Okay guys, so let's get right into it. So the first thing you'll need for your successful wig construction is, of course, a mannequin head. I have a mannequin head, and I've had this mannequin head ever since I started making wigs, which was about 3 years ago, and it's been doing me justice. Yes, it's had a little bit of its brains fall out, but as you can see, I've stitched it on up and it's working perfectly. This is a size 23 head. I got it off of Amazon. I'm pretty sure the link is still available, so I'll attach it in the description box. The next thing you'll need after that is some T-pins to hold everything in place so you don't have to struggle with holding your frontal in place while you're sewing it. You can use T-pins, they're so awesome. I love T-pins so much. You'll need some thread, and then you'll also need the dome cap that you're going to be using to sew your wig on. This is the only wig cap that I use, and I found that it actually does fit almost everyone's head. 90% of the wigs that I do are made on this dome cap, so it's very true to the one size fits all that it claims. So once you got all your supplies together, we're gonna go ahead and put our dome cap on our mannequin head. So if you're using the same dome cap as me, you'll find that you'll have two half circles on your dome cap. So when I place the dome cap on my mannequin head, I have one of the half circles to the front and then the other half circle to the back, just like this. So now we're gonna place our frontal. So when you're placing your frontal on your wig cap, you want the middle part of the frontal to come a little bit ahead of the wig cap. As for the sides of your frontal, you want to push them past the wig cap as well. Do not stretch your sides behind your wig cap, because if you do that, once you put your wig on, the sides of your frontal will fall behind your ear. But what you want to happen is for the sides of your frontal to fall in front of your ear. So it's very important to push the sides of the frontal past the wig cap so that your entire hairline can be covered. Once you have this placement, you want to pin it down with your T-pins and check in the back to see if your frontal is nice and flat. Excuse some of the blonde spots in my frontal. I actually accidentally overbleached some of my knots, but it's okay. Things happen. I fixed it all up and the frontal is still perfect. Okay, so although the back part of your frontal is nice and flat, the front part of your frontal should still be very loose. Once you're done placing your frontal, check to make sure that all the sides are symmetrical so that when they get on your head, everything will look proportionate. I check myself by using the tabs on the back of the lace on each side to check to see if they're about the same length. After I check to see that everything is symmetrical, I can now go ahead and sew down my frontal, simply sewing across from one edge to the other.
Purchase your tracks today.
After my frontal is sewed down, I can now begin sewing in my tracks. I'm just gonna go ahead and take the tail of what was left over from my frontal and use that to start sewing in my tracks.
So around the edges of every dome cap, you'll notice an elastic band on the inside, which helps to stretch the dome cap across any type of head. So when I'm sewing my tracks anywhere on top of the elastic band, I just take the first layer of the cap under my needle. So on the bottom here, you can see me sewing on just the top layer of the dome cap so that I do not disturb the elastic band that's inside of the dome cap. Because I found that when you actually sew onto the elastic band in the dome cap actually loses its elasticity. So you don't want your dome cap to not be stretchy on your head. So I like to sew on top of the elastic band that is within the dome cap. When I get to the ends of my track, I'm going to sew it very closely to the back of my frontal. You want your wig to look together, so you do not want a big division between your frontal and the tracks in your head. Do not sew the track onto the lace, but sew it very closely that there is no space between the track and the lace. For the back of my head, when I'm transitioning into my next track row, I use the flip over method. It's just easier for me and helps me not to make a big mess at the end of my wig session, and just helps the wig making process to go a lot faster. So I use the flip over method, once again, sewing the beginning of this track very closely to the back of the lace. Anytime you begin a new track, you want to stick your needle directly into the weft of your track. I do about 3 direct passes through my weft before I start to go back into my under weft passes through my track. This helps with the little bulge that the flip over method can sometimes make. After that, all you have to do is go directly back and forth sewing in these tracks.
Purchase your tracks today.
Once I get closer to the top, I stop using the fold over method and go on to cut the ends of the track at the end of each row so that the top can be as flat as possible.
Purchase your tracks today.
When I get to the crown of my wig, I do a little something different. Instead of continuing to close up my half circle until I'm finished, I will sew one track across the edge of the lace that I have left.
Purchase your tracks today.
I'll flip up the track and continue filling in the half circle until it is completely closed. I don't know how I started closing it up like this, but it makes the top part of my crown really flat, so I have never left this pattern ever since I've started it. The top part of your wig and finished your last stitch, the only thing you have left to do is cut out the excess part of the wig cap that you have laying under your wig lace.
Purchase your tracks today.
Once that is cut out, your wig is complete.
Thanks again for joining me in yet another video. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. I hope this video helped a ton, and until the next time, I'll see you then.